Alrighty, what is up, my fellow gamers? We're reacting to the new Marvel Spider-Man action sequence trailer. Alright, it's gonna be hype. I can already tell. I'm gonna just turn down my volume. Let's react to it. Alright.
To make a great action sequence, you have to start with a great story sequence.
True. A Marvel Spider-Man behind the scenes.
Fun to watch, but unless you're invested in this character and what they're trying to do, it doesn't mean much.
One of the things I really like about Marvel Comics is when you look at a panel, the characters really pop. You can always see the characters, you know what they're doing.
When we were building out the rest sequence for our E3 demo, we actually went in and we talked with Insomniac a lot about how we could exactly position the villains so we would almost see like these images that flash panels from the comics themselves.
Yo, that
we wanted
art
to try and get that same angle and same framework into these scenes.
We don't actually do storyboards. We actually do a 3D previs. I'm talking about pre-visualization in 3D. The entire file will actually look like what you see in the final product, but it's all grayscale, and then the animators just do temp animations to block out all the scenes, block out the cameras, and then set up the flow of the actual combat. And once we agree upon what we're going to do, we then go to the mocap stage and shoot it.
To achieve both Spider-Man's motion and some of the other more stylized or super
nice.
We drew from everything possible. Right off the bat, we looked at parkour. We actually got amazing things out of our stuff. A lot of wonderful things just sort of bloomed from blue sky thinking on a stage with a stunt person.
What was interesting about working on this project is that there's a lot of different characters. So, for example, we have a flying enemy like Vulture. We have a giant lumbering enemy like Rhino. Or we even have enemies with superpowers like Electro. So we actually have to consider each of the villains as if it's its own main character. So we have to think about the look, the effect, and even how that character moves.
How do you like my new suit? Dashing. Where'd you get it? It's an exclusive club.
If it looks
just
good,
to see that, like, in
once all has the bells and whistles of like finished models and lighting and audio effects, that's just icing the cake.
We actually spent a lot of time making sure that all the surfaces look really wet. You can see at certain times when you look at the characters really closely that there's actually water dripping down their masks or their faces, and I felt that that was really important to really nail the emotion we're trying to get.
There's a sort of gut feeling that it hits your stomach when you have your hands on the sticks and you're playing and you're swinging around and you almost get this moment this state where you're just purely interacting with that world.
Like,
all right, they made a great game. And that's sort of where I've been at, you know, since probably a couple months now, and I'm really, really excited to get this out into the world and see how people react.
Yo, like, just to see that, like, real life and how they do it, I want to do that now. I legit want to make my own game. But anyway, if you guys want to check it out, it's on IGN's channel and Marvel's Entertainment YouTube channel. But anyway, that'll be all for today. I'll see you guys in the next video. Peace. And make sure to web that like button. Why did I say that? I don't even know.